Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Issy Esther K. Welcome back to Enjoy the Works. So today we are going to be teaching on our second part of the Pidgin English. Yes, the last time we talked about how to greet, how are you, and today we are going to be talking about how to ask questions in the Pidgin English. For example, you want to just blend, you know, you want to just blend when you get to one of these African countries, especially in Nigeria, you could easily use the Pidgin English. So, some of the popular questions which people do ask are, what's your name? What's your name is, waiting that they call you. You know, one thing we have to know is that what in the Pidgin English is waiting. What is waiting? So, waiting them they call you, as in how do people call you? Waiting them they call you, or you can say, waiting be your name. Easy like that. Waiting be your name. And then another question. Okay, for example, I get to a new place and I say, my brother, good morning. What's in your name? Then he answers me, my name na Andrew. Or he says, my name na Chidera. That is the answer to the question. Or let me use another name. Or he says, my name na Emmanuel. That is just the answer. Easy like that. Waiting be your name. And the second question that is easily asked, that's usually asked, is, for example, you are in a new place and you don't know the name of the place. You can easily ask, waiting be the name of this place. Oga, we usually call men Oga, or that sometimes women Madam. Just like that, just to add a little respect. Oga, I beg. You know the meaning of I beg? I beg is please. As it goes, we will be getting new words. Oga, I beg. Waiting be this place, or well, waiting be the name of this place. Waiting be the name of this place, or where be this place? You understand? The where is also a real English. You know, I told us in the first part that the Pidgin English is made up of the English, the not so spoken well English, and natural dialects. So you can as well say, waiting be the name of this place, where be this place, or waiting them to call this place. So if I am too fast, please write on the comments that I am too fast. Or if you have any question to ask, you can easily type it on the comment section, you know, and tell me what you want to know. I think to a large extent, I will be able to answer the question. So that is that about asking for where you are in the place. For example, you are in the marketplace. That is also very common. We always ask how much is this, you know. For example, you are in the marketplace and you want to show your skills on Pidgin English and you want to ask, you know, it is not what this time, you understand. Now it is how, which is also taken from the good English, you know. How much be this? Madam, good morning. How much be this? Or you can, how much you dey sell this biro? How much you dey sell this biro? Then she answers and tell you, I dey sell, you know. Most times I am is I dey. I am is I dey. That is, I dey sell am for 5 naira. That is just a simple answer. I am is I dey. How much you dey sell am and you, how much you dey sell am. Dey can also be used also in other terms because dey can also be used as are. How much you dey sell am? How much are you selling? So it is just easy to just like that. How much you dey sell am? I dey sell am for 5 naira. In fact, it's just like that. So then the next question I wrote down was how do I get a bus to this place? Or how do I get a blood bus? You can easily say, Oga, I beg, where I go fit find bus? Where I go fit find bus? Or let us learn it easily now. Then we can go higher and higher as time goes on. Where I go fit find bus? Where I go fit find bus? You understand? So that is also the answer to where can I find a bus? Where can I, or for example, where I go fit find bus with the go Ibadan? That is saying, where can I find a bus that goes to Ibadan in Nigeria? That is a big town in Nigeria. Where I go fit find bus with the go Ibadan? Finish. Where I go fit find bus where they go Ibadan? That is, yeah, can I find a bus that is going to Ibadan? Yes. And so on. So when you try to speak it with ease, I know for the first time of learning languages, it is, you become sort of a little bit nervous, thinking that it's not right, it's not correct. It's also happening to me. But just speak it anyhow. Do you know why? Why you can speak the Pidgin English anyhow is because sometimes different tribes have different ways at which they speak theirs. That is why they can just say, maybe it come from the north, maybe it come from the south, or that maybe it come from the west, or maybe it come from the east. So they would not be able to really, they want to guess and like, maybe not decide from community, but just speak it. They will understand. So that is it on our today's version on Learn Pidgin English with the agenda. Please subscribe to my channel so you can know when I have notifications, and also like the video, and you can as well share the video and tell me also where you want me to improve or where you want me to teach, whatever part you want me to do, let me know. So it's me again, Issy Esther K. Bye, till next video.